Welcome back, my dear students. It's another interesting video session for you. I hope you have completed the recap activity of the first video. Let us start the new lesson. Everyone loves imagination. This lesson is about the imaginary lines which is drawn on the surface of the earth. Can you guess what is that? Yes, of course, it's latitudes and longitudes.
Children, let's do a warm-up club game. Can you all repeat after me? Let's start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Next change. Can you all repeat once again? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Next change.
When you look at the map, you can see the compass which shows the directions north, south, east, west. The map says it's very important to learn what latitude and longitude is. Lines of latitude will measure in the directions north and south. Example, 30 degree S, 20 degree N, etc. The same way, lines of longitude will measure in the directions east and west. That is, 85 degree east, 140 degree west, etc. Latitude, that is, equator divides the earth into northern and southern hemisphere. The same way, longitude, that is prime meridian, divides the earth into eastern and western hemisphere. These are all very useful to locate a place. Now, on the top of the map, if you see, those numbers measure east and west are latitudes. On the sides, if you see, those numbers measure north and south are latitudes. So it's very important for us to understand what latitude and longitude is. Latitudes, these are otherwise known as parallels. Have you seen a railway track? It never meets, but it travels parallel to each other. The same way, all the latitudes are parallels. Each latitude is a circle. The greatest circle is the center one, equator, and it decreases towards the pole as the shape of the earth is bulged at the center and flattened at the poles. The same way, latitudes runs in east to west direction, and all the parallels never meet each other. It crosses the prime meridian at the right angles. And the equator is the greatest circle, whereas the two poles, north and south pole, are the smallest circles. Each latitude is given a number. The equator, center one, is numbered as a degree zero. And the other latitudes, which starts above the equator and it ends at the north pole, it counts 90. The same way, from the equator to the south pole, all the lines of latitude counts 90. So 90 northern hemisphere latitudes and 90 southern hemisphere latitudes and the center equator, totally 181 latitudes on total. The northern hemisphere latitudes are all measured in the direction north. The same way, southern hemisphere latitudes are all measured in the direction S. Now, let us all learn about the important latitudes. The center one, as I said, the greatest circle, equator, has a degree zero. And above the equator, the important latitude is Tropic of Cancer, which has the degree of 23 and a half north. The same way, below the equator, The Tropic of Capricorn measures the degree of 23.5 south. And one more northern hemisphere important latitude is 66.5 degree latitude Arctic Circle. The same way, southern hemisphere latitude 66.5 degree south Antarctic Circle. And the northernmost point and the smallest circle is 90 degree N, and it is referred as North Pole. The same way, southernmost point and the smallest circle in the southern hemisphere is referred as South Pole, and it has a degree of 90 degree S. Let's do the checks for understanding. Which hemisphere are these two latitudes in? 20 degree N, 40 degree S. You can write the answer by my clues. This N and S, the directions, that itself represents the hemispheres. Tick the correct latitude. Which latitude is closer to the equator? 10 degree N and 80 degree N. The smaller is closer to the equator. Which latitude is a smaller circle? 10 degree N or 80 degree N? Larger the latitude number, smaller the circle. Next, you are supposed to find out two countries in which the following latitudes and longitudes passes through. So just check your atlas. Take page number 99 and 100 in your student atlas and refer which two countries that passes through equator. Note it down in your notebook. The same way, Tropic of Cancer, Arctic Circle, Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle, Prime Meridian and International Dateline. Next, take your ruler. Just measure where is 20 degree N and 80 degree E. The intersecting point will give you which country it belongs to. Note it down in your notebook. The same way, 85 degree south and 10 degree east, which country it belongs to. That also note it down in your notebook. Now, before we wind up the session, let's play a game. This is an atlas game. If you want to find out latitudes and longitudes easily, you have to know about the countries and its locations. So, let's start the game. Take your atlas, sit with your parents or siblings. Instruct them to ask any country name. And you have to find out which continent it belongs to. Example, Angola. Which continent it belongs to? Africa. The same way, Chile. Which continent it belongs to? South America. So you are supposed to find out the following country in which continent it belongs to. Cameroon, Ethiopia, Kenya, Libya, Brunei, Cyprus, Lebanon, Albania, Hungary and Monaco. So find out which continent it belongs to through your atlas. Note it down in your notebook. Let's think. Just to scratch your brain, these are the questions. Why is the equator the largest circle of latitude? Have you found out the answer? If you have doubt, I'll give you a clue. Because of the shape of the earth. You know, the shape of the earth is bulged at the center. So, which is the largest circle? Yes, ultimately it's equator. Why do parallels of latitudes go on becoming smaller towards the pole? The same answer for this. Because of the shape of the earth. Have you seen an orange? It's bulged at the center, but it is flattened at the poles. The same way, our globe is also shaped like a geoid. The shape of the earth is geoid shape. It's not a spherical shape, it's geoid shape, bulged at the center and flattened at the poles. So because of that, it is smaller towards the pole. Note down your answers in your notebook. Students, now we come to the closer. Complete the follow-up worksheet after watching the video. Complete the checks for understanding and note it down in your notebook. Sing the song and play the game whenever you find time. Thank you, children. Bye-bye.